Iran's Revolutionary Guard said it had shot down an intruding American spy drone after it entered into the country's territory Thursday. The Revolutionary Guard of Iran, in a statement issued on Thursday, stated, "The drone was launched from a U.S. base south of the Persian Gulf shortly after midnight on Thursday. It said it flew from the Strait of Hormuz towards Chabahar, a city in southwest Iran. While returning to the western Hormuz Straits region, the drone violated Iran's airspace and engaged in information gathering and spying." The statement added, "At 4:05 a.m. local time, while the violating airplane was over Iranian territory, it was shot down." The head of the Revolutionary Guard Corps, Major General Hossein Salami, said the shooting down of the drone had sent a warning to the U.S. "The only way for our enemies to be safe is to respect our sovereignty, national security, and the national interests of the great Iranian nation." U.S. has acknowledged that an RQ-4A Global Hawk high-altitude, long-endurance, HAL, unmanned aircraft system, UAS, has been downed. President Donald Trump has tweeted that Iran made a very big mistake. Trump told reporters in the Oval Office of the White House in a joint media appearance with the visiting Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, "This drone was in international waters, clearly. We have it all documented, scientifically, not just words, and they made a very big mistake." A single RQ-4A Global Hawk costs $131.4 million, excluding R&D expenses. This makes it pricier than an F-35, which now costs around $90 million, and 10 times the price of drones like the Predator and Reaper. It's come as a surprise to many that a sophisticated drone like this can be downed by Iran. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Iran managed to shoot down American RQ-4 Global Hawk, which is one of the best drones in the world. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The U.S. has been flying surveillance drones to spy on Iran for many years. To accord with international law, such flights must take place in international airspace. Aside from the frequent legal reconnaissance flights, Iran has protested what it alleges are violations of its sovereign airspace. It's claimed that two U.S. spy drones crashed in Iran, a Shadow 200 RQ-7, which it said crashed 37 miles inside Iran in Ilam province on July 4, 2005, and a U.S. Hermes drone near Khorramabad, about 125 miles inside Iran, on August 25, 2005. In December 2011, another spy drone was shot inside Iranian territory. The location of the drone in this latest incident has become a key point of contention. Iran maintains that the U.S. aircraft was downed in Iranian territory, while the U.S. claims that it was in international airspace. This comes at a time when relations between the U.S. and Iran have already declined sharply since Donald Trump withdrew from Iran's nuclear deal and reinstated sanctions on Tehran. The Northrop Grumman RQ-4 Global Hawk is an unmanned UAV surveillance aircraft. It was initially designed by Ryan Aeronautical, which is now part of Northrop Grumman. The Global Hawk performs duties similar to that of the Lockheed U-2. The RQ-4 provides a broad overview and systematic surveillance using high-resolution synthetic aperture radar (SAR) and long-range electro-optical infrared (EOIR) sensors with long loiter times over target areas. The Global Hawk carries the Hughes Integrated Surveillance and Reconnaissance (HISAR) sensor system, HISAR integrates a SAR MTI system, along with an optical and thermography imager. All three sensors are controlled and their outputs filtered by a common processor and transmitted in real time at up to 50 megabits per second to a ground station. Global Hawk is capable of taking high definition and infrared images, as well as can intercept telephone and radio chatter. It can survey as much as 40,000 square miles or 100,000 square kilometers of terrain a day. This is equivalent to the size of North Korea or Iceland. Global Hawk has a range of more than 12,000 nautical miles, can fly at very high altitudes of 60,000 feet, and can keep loitering for around 34 hours without break. Global Hawk has no offensive capabilities. KHORDAD 15 is a mobile air defense system which is claimed to be indigenously developed by Iran. It was inaugurated in the presence of Defense Minister Brigadier General Amir Hatami, IRNA reported on Sunday, the 9th of June. The system incorporates a domestically developed radar. Speaking at the unveiling ceremony, Brigadier General Amir Hatami said the system was capable of detecting fighter jets and combat drones from 150 kilometers or 93 miles away and tracking them within a range of 120 kilometers or 75 miles. Interestingly, he said that it can detect stealth targets at a distance of 85 kilometers or 52 miles and engage them within a range of 45 kilometers or 28 miles. According to Iranian Defense Minister Mr. Hatami, the system can be deployed in less than 5 minutes and track 6 targets simultaneously. He added that it can shoot targets at an altitude of 27 kilometers or 17 miles off the ground. Tasnim News Agency stated that the new system has already been delivered to Iran's air defense troops. Some reports suggest that the interceptor missile was a Talish-2B. Global Hawk is a pretty big drone. It has a wingspan of more than 130 feet. To give viewers a perspective, this is similar to a Boeing 737 passenger jet. Global Hawk is not designed to be stealthy, so it is a pretty big target. The Global Hawk is also pretty heavy at more than 16 tons. The weight takes a toll on speed. It can only fly at a maximum of 391 miles per hour or 629 kilometers per hour. This is a bad combo, to say the least. Its large radar signature makes it easy to track by radars, and because of lumbering flight speed, it can be targeted by any decent surface-to-air missile. RQ-4 Global Hawk is suitable for use against insurgent forces such as ISIS or the Taliban that don't have the resources to track and destroy high-flying aircraft. But Iran is not in that league. It actually has multiple platforms that can take out drones such as Global Hawk. Viewers may note that apart from KHORDAD 15, Iran also has Russian-made S-300, which is its most potent air defense system. So the US seems to have lost a drone to an air defense which is not even the best that Iran possesses. S-300 can be equipped with radars that are claimed to have the capability to detect even stealthy aircraft. It's not clear that those actually work properly and if Russia has provided them to Iran or not. Iran is thought to possess 4 batteries each of S-300P and S-300PMU-2. Keeping these aspects in view, Defense Updates has already suggested that S-300 is one weapon the US must be wary. To check that analysis, view the video on the above card. The US currently doesn't have high-end drones that are fast and stealthy, which are hard to shoot down, nor have cheap and numerous drones that's more or less expendable. So there's definitely a gap between US's current drones and capabilities of rivals like Iran. The gap will only be larger when faced by Russian and Chinese air defense. In 2015, the US Navy was working with a pair of experimental low observable combat drones, the X-47B developed by Northrop Grumman. The US Navy had shelved them in citing cost and reoriented the program to develop a drone tanker. Looking at the current situation, the decision seems to have backfired. The US is working on a cheap and stealthy drone named Valkyrie. It costs only $2 to $3 million per piece. It remains to be seen how this project goes.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.